Counsel for the accused has been very eloquent in his description of the long-suffering mother. Unfortunately, very little has been said about the rights of the child. Even less has been said about the accused's moral obligation to the law of the land. This obligation will not be seen to be taken lightly in this courtroom. Catherine Maxwell, I sentence you to the maximum penalty by law, life imprisonment.
Bastards. It was a plastic gun. 6 months for a plastic gun. Well, they can stick it, because there's no way that I'm going back there. I'm getting out as soon as I... Oh, watch what you're doing, you stupid bastards! Well, say something, will you? I'm talking to you, you stupid bitch. Look, I told you what happened to me. What did you cop?
G'day, Slimy. What you watching?
It's stuff.
Where's Merle?
Ask the Warriors. You reckon they're looking after her now?
Good, I'm hungry. Anyone know what's for tea?
Williams.
Yeah? What's it gonna be, Slime?
I mean, she's it.
You bitch, Wilkinson, you told them.
Here's your quick, Slimy. I thought you were never going to turn around.
What do you want?
Little Dickie Bird told us you've been telling fibs.
Yeah, well, she's a bloody liar.
Oi, that's my mate you're talking about, Lexie.
Oh, yeah, well, she didn't understand what I was doing. I mean, Kat's not coming back, is she? So I was just getting Looney ready
Merle.
For
Merle.
Yeah, I was just getting Merle ready for
her. Oh, you were doing a good turn. And here's us thinking nasty things about it.
What are you going to do?
What do you think? We're going to give you a good kicking, a real good kicking, just to remind
you. Hang on, I can hear someone.
Split up.
Lexie, don't. What's all the excitement?
Oh.
What's so bloody funny? She got away.
Big deal.
Let her sweat.
We'll get her next time.
You bitches. Sorry, mate, you might have helped me out. I just had a go at Connors and her mates, and I think they're after me. Well, come on, I did it for you.
Did what?
Stuck up for you and Kath. You know that name they started calling you? Well, they're doing it again. Only this time they made up a song about it, and they're laughing like crazy. Yeah, that was bad enough. But then they started getting stuck into Kath, and that's when I really got mad. Yeah, they reckon Kath's a kid killer, and she didn't really like you at all.
She does, she's my friend.
Yeah, yeah, I know all that. But they reckon she's only using you. Well, come on, will you?
They said that? They said that about Kath? She likes me fighting.
Look, she's just saying that because she thinks she'll get hurt. She doesn't know what a good fighter you are.
She does. Her and me are going to fight crime when I get out, she said.
Right, and that's what you and I are doing. We're fighting the crooks that are saying bad things about Kath.
Maybe if I just tell them not to do it again.
Oh, don't be stupid. Look, as soon as your back's turned up... Look, if the judge hears about it and he thinks it's all true, he might change his mind and send Kath to Blackmore or something.
Oh, you reckon?
Yeah. And that's why you and I have to stop Connors and the rest of them. Now do you understand?
Yeah.
Look, I still reckon we should have gone after him.
Oh, quit worrying. I want to stick around and get some news from the courts anyway.
And when do you think we'll hear something?
I don't know. Shouldn't be too much longer if Auntie Ida's been here.
I heard something a while ago you're not going to like. Oh, don't worry, it's not about Auntie Ida.
Oh, yeah?
Look as if work experience is off.
Who says?
Well, I overheard Mr. Jackson and Miss Stout talking in the kitchen. It seems if they can't get any businesses to go along with.
Are you sure about that?
Well, that's what they said. So it looks as if we're going to have to forget about the whole thing.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't start celebrating too early.
Get Connors first. Go on.
What have you done to her?
Yeah, what have you said?
Who cares? They're enough of us. Let's
go. No, she's the one who said it.
Said what?
Move. Get the bitch. Go on.
She been telling you, Murray?
I'm not letting you say bad things about Kath.
I haven't been saying anything.
She's lying. Kill her.
All right, Murray, if that's what you want, go ahead. I'm not going to fight you.
See? She's scared brainless. This is your chance.
She's the one who's using you. She's the one who's lying.
You hate Kath. I know you do.
I used to. I still don't like her much. But at least we're starting to understand each other. And the last thing she wants is for you and me to be fighting. Hasn't she told you that?
Don't listen to her.
That's right, Murray. Work it out for yourself. What did Kath want you to do?
I don't know! I'll kill you, stay away!
Go on, break the bitches back!
Hey, Lexie, Rita knows what she's doing.
You reckon?
Look,
What happens if you don't move? What happens to Kath will be your fault. Do you hear me? Your fault!
Lexie, Lorelei, get after her.
Courier should be here in 15 minutes, Beth.
What's the matter with Stout and Jackson?
Why?
I just saw them a few minutes ago. They've both got long faces about something.
They're disappointed. They put a lot of effort into the work release scheme. Seems as though they wasted their time.
That surprises you?
Yes, quite frankly. Not everyone shares your view of the women.
Well, look who's back.
What happened?
Brown got a 2-year bond. Walter's another 6 months.
Yeah. 6 more bloody months. That mongrel judge had it in for me right from the start.
Oh, be quiet.
Well, he did. I shouldn't be back in here and you know it.
You heard, Miss Ferguson. Now be quiet.
What about Maxwell?
Life.
All right. I'd like to talk to the two of you in my office as soon as the formalities are over.
You got life? Bloody hell, why didn't you say so?
Hey, papers. Thanks. Okay, on the line.
Oh, look, we've already done all
get
this.
On the line. Catherine Maxwell, you've been found guilty of manslaughter and sentenced to life imprisonment. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Come on, Lexie. Oh, she's all right.
You all right, Merle? What's the matter? No one's going to hurt you. No, she's terribly upset. Don't worry.
No one's going to hurt.
We're just upsetting her more. Come on, Rita, we want to.
Go and get Rita, quickly.
I feel
like you.
Same. Lock the door.
Why? In case she tries to bolt.
Well, how do you know she's here?
Because we've looked everywhere else.
Grab her!
You got her?
Yeah, I got her.
Oh, you might as well stop thrashing around, bitch. It's going to be harder for you if you don't.
I'm going to kill you bitches for this!
Makes you think you're going to live through.
Rita, we need you. It's Merle. She's trying to kill herself. Come quickly. We've got to stop her.
Well, it's not up to me to question a court decision. But to be quite honest, I really didn't think we'd be seeing you back here today.
Nice surprise for both of us, then.
You are filing an appeal, of course.
My solicitor's talking about it.
Good.
Oh, yes, wonderful. Where do I get the money for an appeal? I've spent every cent I had getting this far.
You can apply for legal aid.
I had one of the best lawyers. He couldn't get me off. What chance do you think I've got with some kid from legal
aid?
You
have to try.
That's what you said about today. That if I played my cards right and told the judge how sorry I was, everything would be all right. Well, I did that. I threw out everything I believed in. I told them what they wanted to hear. What good did it do?
If I gave you bad advice, I'm sorry.
It wouldn't have mattered what I said. It wasn't that he didn't believe me. He just didn't care. Well, I'm not putting myself through that again.
You'll change your mind when you've had time to come. Yes? Have you called the doctor? I'll come now. I'm not sure whether I should tell you this, but you might be the one person who can help. It's Merle Jones.
Why, what's happened?
She's just been taken to the infirmary. It looks like attempted suicide.
Attempted? Why?
I'm going there to find out. Do you want to see her?
Yes, of course I do.
No!
It won't hurt. It'll make you feel better.
Merle?
No, wait. I'll ask Sister Hall.
Kath!
I've just sedated her. She'll quieten down in a minute.
I thought Maxwell might be able to help. Can she talk to her?
Kath!
It can hurt, but the doctor will be here soon.
All right, go on.
It's all right. I'm here. I'm back. I'm not going to let them hurt you anymore.
They're not sending you to that other place, are they?
No, what made you think that?
Someone said that. Well, I was fighting so they wouldn't say bad things about you. But you said don't fight. I didn't know what to do. I'm sorry, Kath, honest.
It's all right. Why did you hurt yourself?
So the bad feeling had stopped. It stopped sometimes when I hurt people and I break things, but I knew you'd be mad if I did. So I hurt the feeling in my head. You're not mad, are you?
No.
You going home?
No, I'm staying here with you. You close your eyes and get some sleep now, all right?
Yeah. I feel sleepy.
I know you do. Close your eyes. I'll be here when you wake up.
Are you sure she did this to herself? Couldn't have been the other women.
No. They stopped her going any further.
I wonder what triggered it off.
Look, I can't be sure, but from her reactions and the way she looked when she came in, I don't think she's been taking a medication.
But surely you'd know that.
Oh, I've been giving it to her, and in the past she's been very good taking it without any trouble. But, well, like I say, I can't be sure. It's just the only explanation I can see.
I suppose Merle's going to be all right.
It's a brick wall I'm worried about.
She'll be pretty bloody sore for a couple of days.
Yeah, so are Williams when we get to her.
Should have shoved the bitch in the dryer when we had her.
We'll get her. This time it'll be twice as bad for her.
Shouldn't we be out looking for her now?
Bitches sticking to the screws like glue. We've got Len and Martha keeping tabs on her. The minute she's on her own, we'll know and then we'll get her.
Here you go.
Roach!
Hi.
Wasn't expecting to see you back. What happened?
Mungle bloody judge didn't like me, that's what.
Oh, I know how you feel. How long did you get?
6 months. On top of what I've already done.
What about Ida?
She got off on a bond. Same as I should have. The whole thing stinks.
Oh, well, 6 months? It'll go quick enough.
In here? You gotta be kidding.
You'll survive just like the rest of us. What about Maxwell?
Well, she wouldn't talk to me on the way back. When I found out why, bloody hell.
Was she back then?
Is she ever? She got life.
Life?
Jeez, that's heavy.
Poor thing, she was expecting a transfer, maybe even a bond.
Where is she then?
I took her up to the infirmary to see Merle. What happened?
Kept her from killing herself, didn't we?
Why? At least she would have got out of this stinking joint.
Look, with Maxwell back in here, that means we've got our whole back over Ferguson and you won't have...
No way. Maybe once, but she'll have covered her tracks by now.
You don't know that.
Bet on it. There's only one way to get Ferguson off our backs.
Well, I don't care what anyone says. 6 months isn't fair. And I'm not just going to sit around and take it.
Look, come on, it's not that bad. We were all talking before how we're going to make things fun around here again, eh?
Well, any time I tried to have a bit of fun, you lot jumped on me. But go ahead, have your fun. Just keep off my back.
Oh, St. John's?
Oh, I think she's okay. They stopped her before she could do herself any real damage.
It's a pity a decent-sized headache might have quietened her down.
So would the medication. But apparently she hasn't been taking it.
Well, that just proves she shouldn't be here in the first place. If she was in an institution, she could be looked after properly.
Hey!
What do you think you're doing?
You've got to help me. They're going to kill me.
Who?
Take your pick. They're all in it together.
They must have a good reason.
I won't take orders from them, that's what it is. But you've got to help me.
You tell me why they're going to kill you and I might think about it.
They're blaming me because Joan's been off her trolley today.
Uh-huh.
Well, she has. Well, are you going to help me or what?
Why are they blaming you?
She hasn't been taking her medication. She's been giving it to me instead.
You?
Well, not to take. I've been keeping it. Thought I might find a use for it.
I bet you would have.
Well, I can't keep away from them forever. And if I have to front up to Reynolds, I might have to tell her what I know. So you're going to help me or what?
Don't you threaten me, Williams. Get in here.
What for?
You want somewhere to hide, don't you? And believe it or not, it's my job to help prisoners. Even you.
Just get him to leave me alone.
I think she's just about asleep. She'll be all right now.
I'll stay a bit longer, if that's all right.
Oh, just a bit longer.
It's all right. I'm still here.
I told her I shouldn't stop taking medicine.
What's that, Mom?
Janet said, all right, give him to her.
Mom, what are you saying? Janet took your medication?
I told her... make me bad. But I didn't.
There's no point in your staying any longer.
What if she wakes up again?
She won't, not for a good while. Now, you report to the officer at the security gate and she'll take you back. There's no need to worry. She'll be fine.
Yes, all right. Something I have to do anyway.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going to see the governor.
What for?
I'll tell her when I see her.
Let me guess. You want to tell her all about Williams conning Jones out of taking her medication, right?
What do you know about it?
Everything. There's nothing goes on here that I don't know about. I thought you'd have woken up to that by
now. I'm still going to go and see the governor. No way Merle's going to get sent to an institution for something Williams did.
You know what they do to laggers, don't you?
That's my worry. Damn it, give me that! Give them!
Saving you from yourself, Maxwell. One day you'll thank me for it.
Forget it, Ferguson. Reynolds is going to hear about this. And if those caps aren't here when she comes looking for them, I'm going to tell her all about your part in the drug deals.
I'm getting very tired of hearing about that.
Too bad, because you're going to be hearing a lot more about it.
Shut up, Maxwell. Now, you listen to me for a minute. You're in here for life, right? That could be about 12 years if you behave. If not, it could be forever. Now, you lag on Williams and it will take 5 minutes for her to tell everything about the drug scam. Everything! And what do you think that's going to do to your chances?
I don't care!
Oh, but you will. Not now, maybe, but this thing could cost you another 5 years. Just think, you could be in here for 20 years, Maxwell.
I'll worry about that later. I'm not letting Williams get away with this.
She's not going to.
What do you mean?
I've taken care of it. Williams will get what's coming to her. She won't be saying anything to anyone.
You really expect me to believe that?
Maxwell, you're not on remand anymore. I think it's about time you started pulling your weight around here. I'm going to put you on cleaning duties.
What?
You can start with the dorm at the end of the corridor.
What are you playing at, Ferguson? That dorm's empty.
Is it?
Williams and we'll check this out.
Well, there's no sign of her. Otherwise, I'd have taken her and searched the cell already.
You'd better find some sign of her, fast. Where did the information about these capsules come from, anyway?
Well, Mrs. Morris told me what Sister Hall said, and it started me thinking. I know you don't approve of informants,
no,
but...
No, I don't. I'm going to get to the bottom of this straight away. There she is! Get the bitch!
Away. Emma, get Rita! I warned you! Out the beach! Leave her, she's mine!
Why should you have all the fun?
Because this is for Merle. Now, leave out of it.
All right, if that's the way you want it, everyone get back. Give him room. Lexie, keep this.
Oh, you got to be kidding. I'm not missing this for
quick. Rodney, Jacko, get out of it. In the corridor.
You're not going to let Williams get on top of you, are you?
Nah. Looks like she'll be all right.
But you haven't seen Janet Williams anywhere?
No. Well, most of the women are in the rec room. She could be there.
Go for it! Chunk the bitch!
Yeah, finish her off! Finish her off!
Go, go, go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go!
You wanted her dead.
I do, but not like this. Not like a public spectacle.
It's up to you. Sooner or later, somebody's going to do it for you.
The governor's coming. Everybody out. Come on, move. They'll catch you here.
Let them.
Are you off your brain? Leave her and come on. Stuff you. Do what you like.
Knock her out of the letter straight away. She can't be fast. She's not smart enough to come up with any sort of workable escape plan.
Then you go. If you've got something to say, you better get it off your chest now. Nothing to talk to but the walls in here.
Better company than most around here.
Oh, is that nice? After I've handed you Williams on a plate, the least you could do is say thank you.
You did it because it suited your purposes. I suppose you were hoping we'd kill each other.
Yes. But it worked out quite well enough. I think your friend's going to keep a low profile from now on, after Sister's finished patching her up.
They haven't taken her to the infirmary. Merle's there.
We're not completely stupid, Maxwell. She's gone to isolation. After that business with the capsules, she won't get within a mile of your pet gorilla. Oh, you handled yourself pretty well today. I think you might have a future in here, providing you can keep yourself together and not throw a wobbly at the drop of a hat.
Get out.
Oh, but you haven't said thank you.
I don't owe you a thing or anyone else in here, but I'll tell you something. I've let you and the women and the whole rotten system grind me down as far as it's going to. Now I know the rules. So from now on, I'm going to be doing a lot more than just surviving.
Is that right?
Try me.
Great job you did of protecting me.
Don't know what you're whinging about. You got what you wanted.
How do you figure that?
The governor is transferring you to A block, away from Maxwell and Jones, as of tonight.
Well, that doesn't change anything. Maxwell could have killed me. So why shouldn't I blow the whistle on you?
Don't even think about it. You're only safe in A block as long as the women can't get to you. I can always arrange a little visit from one of them.
You wouldn't risk it.
Oh, there's no risk at all. And if you're still alive after that, the next stop will be Blackmore. I've got a friend there. She'll give you quite a reception.
Here.
Oh.
A search of your cells revealed a number of capsules. How do you explain it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
They're sedatives, prescribed for and given to Merle Jones. I want to know how you got them.
I told you I don't know what you're talking about. Maybe Looney hid them there.
Why would Jones do that?
I don't know. She's a simp, isn't
she? Stop wasting my time, Williams. She's still sedated, but she said quite enough for me to put two and two together. You deliberately tricked her out of taking her medication. I can only imagine it was so that you could use her against the other women.
That's all just guessing. I'm the one who was bashed. What are you going to do to Maxwell?
If I were you, I'd be thankful I got off as lightly as you did. Now, for the record, I want a full admission of what happened.
What for, you know so much?
I want it from you.
All right. The women were giving me a hard time. Jones was my protection. It was self-defense.
Who are your accomplices?
I haven't got any.
I don't believe that. You're not the loner type. So who's been helping you?
I told you. I don't need anyone working for me. And I don't work for anyone.
They'll be here with the slides any minute, so hurry up.
Yeah. Hey, I wonder if they took any during lights out.
Don't know, Merv might have had a good flash.
Maxwell's in the pound. Williams is in with Renault and the freak.
I bet she's lying her head off. She's probably shifting all the blame onto Maxwell.
Well, I don't know. Word is she's been transferred to A block.
Or to transfer her to a hole in the ground.
She came pretty close to a hole in the ground this afternoon. Maxwell's not the wimp I thought she was.
No, except she went to water at the last minute.
She did not go to water. She found out she couldn't kill another human being.
Human? Williams? You gotta be joking.
Hey, what about Merle?
As far as I can find out, she's all right. Pretty doped up, but.
Well, here we are. Oh,
yes. You know them in the magazines, we'll be right to go.
I'll give you a hand.
Oh, well, the bit with the writing goes towards you and facing up.
Oh, what writing?
Just be careful, Alice. Don't put your fingerprints on them, please.
Oh, Lurch leaves the daubs on everything. That's how she got caught in the first place.
You know, Rita, you could learn a lesson from Kath.
What do you mean?
When it came to it, she couldn't kill Williams, no matter how much she might have deserved it. Cold-bloodedly taking somebody else's life is wrong.
Oh, Alice.
Oh, geez, I'm sorry, Mrs. P. I sort of jumped
them. Well, look, you go and help the others. Mervyn and I will do this.
No, you do it, love. There's something I want to check in the kitchen.
Oh, right.
Oh, come on, Roach. It's not every day you go along on a honeymoon.
Leave me alone, will you?
You can't sulk forever.
I'm not sulking. I just don't feel like talk.
I just wish people would leave me alone.
Can't believe everyone was so negative. Wouldn't you think there'd be just one person prepared to give it a try?
I told you it wouldn't work, but you had to find out the hard way.
Oh, I can't think why we didn't believe you, Rodney. I mean, you're always so open-minded about other people's ideas.
Oh, come on, everyone knows how prisoners treat work-release schemes. They think it's a great joke.
Yeah, they all think you're a great joke too, but it doesn't mean you shouldn't be given a chance.
Hey, come on, guys. We're supposed to be relaxing here. All this bickering, I can't hear the music.
Who wants to? It sounds like a funeral march. Doesn't he know anything more modern?
He's a she, and it sounds all right to me.
No offence, Marty, but your taste in music's a pit. Tell you what, she doesn't look half bad, though.
Well, I was wondering when you'd notice.
I might go over and give her a few tips on improving her repertoire.
I bet she'd really appreciate that.
Don't, Rodney. You'll only make a fool of yourself.
Who? Rod?
We'll see, won't we?
Back against the wall, Maxwell.
What is this, interrogation time again?
Would you mind coming with us?
I've already told you I've got nothing to say. What happened this afternoon was between Williams and me.
We know all about it. Just come with us, please.
Why? Must be a good reason for the governor to come looking for me.
To be quite honest with you, I'm not at all happy about releasing you from here, but Sister Hall's made an urgent request for you to go to the infirmary.
The infirmary? What's happened?
Nothing to worry about. The sedatives don't seem to be having much effect. Merle's awake again. She's calling for you. Sister doesn't want to give her anything stronger. You may be able to settle her down again.
I wanted to stay with her before, but the stupid woman
just
wouldn't let
me. Just calm down, Max. She was asleep before. Sister didn't expect her to wake up for hours. Now, come on, we're wasting time.
What happens to her once she gets over this?
I haven't decided yet.
You can't send her to a home. None of this was her fault. You know that.
Yes, I do. But Wentworth may not be the best place for her.
Do you know why she hurt herself as badly as she did? Because she preferred that to hurting somebody else. She is not insane and she's not bad-natured. She's just a big, confused kid.
If Williams could trick her like that, so could the other women. We can't have that happening again.
It won't. I guarantee it. I'll take personal responsibility. Just give her another chance.
Well, I'll have to read the psychiatrist's report before I make a decision. But the report from the staff and the deputy governor do state that she's perfectly manageable when she's with you.
You mean Ferguson actually told the truth for once?
I'll ignore that, Maxwell. Now I think we'd better get to the infirmary.
I don't want to stay here. Let me out.
No,
I want to
get out. All right. It's all right. It's only so you don't hurt yourself.
They're going to kill me.
No, they're not. It's Kath. You must have had a bad dream.
I want to get out. I want to get out.
Well, I'm going to let you up now. You hold still.
Now, Maxwell, don't. Look, the only thing wrong with her is that she's terrified of those straps. Loosen them and I can calm her down.
Not without a stronger sedative.
Wait! Let me show you something. I'll only loosen one strap.
You were told no.
You brought me here to help her. Now give me a chance.
One strap can't hurt, can it?
I suppose not.
One strap.
Well, it's Kath and I'm taking off the straps, all right?
Kath!
No more straps, that's right. See, the straps are coming off.
Take them off, I'm scared.
That's the first strap off. Now, do you promise me you'll lie still while I take off the...
Lie still. Take them off. Girl, I'm scared. Hurry.
One strap off and she's calmer already. Let me do the rest and I promise you she'll be fine.
Wait a minute. She does seem calmer.
How long? That's the thing.
Okay. Well, that's another one off. Now, do you promise me you'll lie very, very still when they're all off?
Are you going to stay with me?
Yes, if you be good.
I will. I promise.
That's a good girl. Okay, well, there's nothing to worry about, is there? Nothing to be scared of at all, is there?
Now, this is me getting ready for my first run down the slopes.
Hey, you look like a real champion, Mrs. Creeper.
Well, I was feeling quite confident. We had spent all morning with an instructor.
Where's Merle?
Oh, he took the picture.
Of him.
Yes, in a minute. Yes, in a minute. Well, now, here's me starting down the slope. I wasn't feeling quite so confident now, but as you can see, I made it to the bottom. There I am, coming past the home flag.
What about moving?
Yes, well, the next one is him. Here he goes. There he is, at the bottom of the run. He tripped.
Oh, I do hope he didn't hurt himself.
Oh, no, no. He picked himself up, brushed off the snow, and he was as good as new. And he decided not to try it again. Now, this next one is the chalet where we stayed. Oh, but that's Paris. How did that get in there?
Hey, that's not Moonbeer and his buttocks.
Oh, I don't know how they got mixed up like that.
They must have been the ones I helped you with. Let me see.
No, it's all right, Alice. I can do it.
Oh.
What happened?
Oh, unfortunately, the power's gone off.
Well, the light's on outside, Mrs. Pringle.
Oh, it's awfully dark in here.
Now, look, please, someone, let's just behave yourselves and someone turn on the light.
Mrs. P, I didn't touch her.
Well, look, Alice, what are you doing?
Oh, geez, I'm sorry, Mrs. P, I must have kicked the plug out.
Oh, well, just go and sit down and we'll start all over again, all right? Yes. Now, the next one, as you can see, is me in the Champs-Élysées by the Arc de Triomphe.
Knock, knock, can I come in?
Oh,
what a surprise. Whoever heard of pictures would have popcorn.
Oh, beautiful. Hey, can I have some?
Plenty for everyone.
Hey, cheers, Mr. Pringle.
Hip, hip, hooray! Hip, hooray!
All freshly made with lashings of butter.
Hey, I'll give you a hand.
Hey, Alice, watch out for the power cord.
Come on, let's go before he gets really drunk and everything gets out of hand.
No, we can't.
Why not? You can't tell me you're enjoying yourself.
We can't just leave him here.
Marty, he's not going to listen to you anyway.
If we leave him here, the fool will only get into trouble.
Oh, Marty, as bad as your mum.
Worse.
Oh, bloody hell, where do you think you're going?
Me? Up yours with the grappling hook, sonny. You're the one, of course.
And you're the one standing in everyone's way, so why don't you go sit down before someone knocks you down?
And who are you thinking might do that?
What are you on about?
Thought it was pretty clear. Maybe if you shut your big mouth for a second, you'd hear what people say.
You're right, trouble.
No.
Hey, Mickey! What's a low-life character like you doing in a respectable place like this?
Marty, where the hell do you spring from?
Oh, I've been around, but what about you? Where have you been hiding? I haven't seen you since you left the service.
I've been making an honest living. What's your excuse? Yeah, this is my uncle, Captain Muldoon.
How'd you be, matey?
Ah, so you're the captain. Sky never stopped talking about you. Hey, come on over. I've got a table and a food. Come and have a drink.
Yeah, talk me.
Hey, heard a story. You're out of the old sea circus now, that's
right. Sure is.
Why, what happened?
Oh, I developed this pathological fear for sharks, especially two-legged ones in officers' uniforms.
Oh, dear, they got two legs.
And this is the little cottage in the Cotswolds where we stayed for a week.
Oh, so what?
Cotswolds, Lexie. Hills in the west of England where the Thames River starts.
Oh, it's such beautiful, unspoiled countryside. You can see it stretching away for miles. Little villages, farms in the distance.
It's so green, isn't it?
Green.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the air was so fresh. And many lovely birds and flowers. Merle and I walked for miles every day. And there were always new things to see.
Oh, it's nice. Hey! Oh,
what's wrong with Roach? Is she sick?
It wasn't my popcorn. She didn't have any.
I'll find out, Mrs. P.
Hey, Rich, what's eating you?
Nothing. I'm just going to be doing all right.
Look, I know you're snaky about being back inside, but you just got to make the best of it.
You call that making the best of it? Sitting there watching pictures of things that we're never going to see. Do you think that we're ever going to go skiing in Switzerland or walk around some bloody big hill in England?
Listen, the sooner you stop talking like that and start facing facts, the better. It tastes really great. You sure you don't want to
shove it?
It's time to move on, Cap. Let's face it, I wasn't officer material.
Well, what about this job you're doing now? I don't think I'd like it. Locked in all day with a cargo of women crims.
I mean, not exactly locked in.
Yeah, anyway, a lot of them aren't that bad.
What do you mean by that exactly? You reckon some of them must get a bit toey, you know what I mean?
Trouble with these Navy types, they judge everyone by themselves.
I can believe it.
Hey, what sort of work do you have to do? Just walk around and make sure they're not going over the side? Or...
There's a bit more to it than that. For instance, we're trying to organise this work release scheme, but we're not having much luck.
What's work release?
Well, some of the women are allowed to take outside jobs during the day.
Oh, make them earn their keep, eh?
It's not that so much. It's to help prepare them for going back into the workforce after they're released.
It'd be a really good thing, but the idea's a dead duck. No employer wants to know us.
I wonder why.
If the captain here's such a good friend of yours, why doesn't he take some of them on in his boatyard?
I thought you were going home.
I'd like to see the woman could match the pace I set. No offence to present company, of course.
You'd be surprised. Those women are tough. Some of them can outwork any man I know.
And could they outsteer and outrun a man as well? They stuck him in the brig for some reason, you know. Turn me back for 10 seconds, I'll be clean out.
Oh, that's not fair. You don't even know them.
I don't want to either.
Why not, Cap? They're a good lot. One thing these women understand is loyalty. You give them a break, and they'll do the right thing by you.
Just a minute, are you trying to... Ah, Marty, hell and... Look, I just don't think I could take the chance.
No, I know. That's what everyone says. Guess it was a pretty stupid idea right from the start.
Didn't I tell you that?
Oh, you don't like it, eh?
No, it's a stupid idea. Who in their right mind would want to take on a bunch of hardened crims?
Oh, they're not, Rodney, and you know it.
Well, you can convince me it's so important to you.
How am I supposed to do that?
I reckon a couple of old seafarers like you and me could come up with an idea, eh?
I'm sorry this happened, Merle. It was my fault and I'm sorry.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't your fault, Kat.
Yes, it was. I told you not to fight and look what happened.
I'm all right, honest.
Yes, but you could have been very badly hurt. Well, nothing like that's ever going to happen again to either of us.
I know. I'll take my medicine, like you said.
Yes, I know, because it makes you feel better. But from now on, we're not going to be friends with anyone but each other. I was wrong to think we could be. We're just going to do what we have to take care of ourselves, okay?
Okay.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is a friendly little contest. Just to see if this young ex-sailor can outdrink an old sea dog.
Let's get this straight. If I do, you'll accept some of our women for work experience.
That's right. If you last the distance.
Well, look, you know how much this scheme means to me, but I don't think this is the way to do it.
Neither am I.
Now we know why a boy left the Navy. Couldn't hold his rum.
Here. Looks like you'll be driving home tonight.
Hey, McPherson.
Yeah?
Come in here, I want to talk.
Yeah?
I'm going to get out of here and I need a bit of help.
Get out? What for?
What sort of stupid question's that?
Oh, geez, you only got 6 months. Not even that with good behaviour.
Well, whatever it is, it's too much. Look, I'm going to go off my brain if I have to stay in here another month. So you're going to help or not?
Well, what am I supposed to get out of it? The whole place knows you haven't got a cent.
Maybe. Look, I can do better than money. While I'm still in here, well, you can have my buy-up and I'll help you any way you like. Then once I go, I'll be your contact on the outside.
Great contact. You'd be every cop in town breathing down your neck.
Okay, but don't forget the gang. Look, I can set you up and in with them. You can work all kinds of deals with them outside helping.
Well, how do I know they'd do it? I only got your say-so.
I'll get word out to them before I go, and then that way we'll...
Hey, why didn't you stay? Everyone had a great time.
I've got to go.
What are you talking to her for?
Nothing. I'm going to work.
Oh, easy, easy.
Your turn.
Come on, Marty. Come on, Marty.
Come on.
You can do it, mate.
This could get interesting. People kill themselves playing this, you know.
You should take it up.
Come on. Come on, Marty. Come on, mate.
Mervyn, look, it's crowded. Let's leave it to another night.
Oh, you don't call that a crowd, love. And anyway, I'm in the mood for a bit of socialising.
Mervyn Pringle, you know you're not supposed to drink. Now, what is this?
I can have a soft drink. Now, stop being a party pooper. Let's see what the excitement's about.
Oh, Mrs. Pringle.
Oh, Delia. What's everyone celebrating?
I'm not sure.
It's a drinking contest.
It's not, well, not really a contest.
It had nothing to do with me. I was out the back when it started.
Just testing the boy's mettle. You better hang around. He might need some help to carry him out.
Oh, well, well, we just dropped in for a moment. We're not staying. Come on, Mervyn. Come on.
What's up?
We don't want to spoil their fun.
Nonsense. Well, stay and watch.
Mervyn Pringle, what is the matter with you? I know you don't like drinking in bars, and any other night you can't wait to get home in front of the telly. Now, what is going on?
Look, Josie, I don't begrudge you letting Joan Ferguson stay with us for a couple of nights. I suppose it's the least we can do, but I just don't want to stay in the flat with her any more than I can help.
Mervyn, don't be silly. She's probably gone to bed by now anyway.
Well, let's stay a little bit longer just to make sure, all right?
Maxwell, wake up.
It's all right.
She'll sleep through the night now. You can go back to your dorm.
I don't mind staying.
Well, you appreciate what you did. It made all the difference, but you have to go back now.
Thank you.
Joan.
Hello. Thought you'd have been home ages ago.
Oh, no. Had a little celebration. Oh, it's all right, Mervyn, dear. I am perfectly capable of walking in my own home without assistance.
Ashley, I think you'd better come to bed, Joyce. We've all had a little bit too much excitement.
Yes, we have, haven't we? What was the occasion?
Oh, Marty beat the captain. Our side won. Work experience is not off anymore. It's on.
What?
It's just a harmless little contest. Oh, if you excuse me, I'd better get Joyce to bed.
Oh, Mervyn, what are you doing?
Don't be silly, darling.
Don't
come
keep
along.
Touching me. No, Joanie, all right. Tell him to behave himself.
Come along,
he's
Benny.
A bit of a devil,
Come on, Hornblower, on your feet.
How's the time? The ship sails without me, I'm dead.
You're not dead, just dead drunk. The only thing you have to worry about is making it to work in the morning.
We start work at 0500 hours. Tell that to those women of yours. And if they're a minute late, the deal's off.
Tomorrow? Well, you can't organise it that soon.
Well, whenever.
I hope you're satisfied. We'll all be on the carpet over this.
Why?
You think Joyce Pringle's not going to report it?
Why should she? We didn't do anything wrong, and as far as I could see, she was having the time of her life.
Oh, bull. She was just giving us enough rope to hang ourselves. Well, I told her it's nothing to do with me.
Good. Remember that when everyone's congratulating us on the work release scheme.
I tell you now, it'll be a disaster. Governor wouldn't have agreed in the first place if it had been anyone but Mummy's little pet here.
Oh, just shut up, Rodney.
No, Del. Let him go. After all, he's said it enough times. What he means is that my mother is unfairly using her position to help me. Isn't that right, Roddy?
Well, everyone knows it's true.
Rodney!
Just like everyone knows why you always stick up for him.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun.